And so it's all about treating people with dignity. And it's about making sure that, look, I mean, for example, look at the heat I'm getting because I named the Secretary of Defense, the black man. I named Ketanji Brown. I mean, because of the people I've named.
You mean Lloyd Austin? Ketanji Brown Jackson is the Supreme Court justice, you desiccated old turd. Yeah, one has a vagina, one doesn't. They're totally different. He's just like, what other black people doing? Oh, going through the Rolodex in his head, which is struggling. It's got one card and it's torn up. Welcome back to the program. Dana Loesch here with you. The bottom of this first hour. He's just sitting there. Was he trying to say that people were mad because Lloyd Austin's black? Because that's brand new to me. Yes. I mean, not that he's black, but that anybody's mad about it. Nope, he's completely incompetent. It has nothing to do. Is that the goal? Like, Democrats, just let's put in the most completely incompetent, irresponsible person we can into this position and make sure they're a minority. So that way, if we get any criticism, we can be like, you're racist. Is that the goal? Is that the strategy here?
You make it sound so simple and dumb, but that's exactly their goal.
That's exactly what they're doing.
That's exactly what it is.
Totally what they're doing. That's exactly it. I'm just saying, you know, just seems a little, it seems a little transparent. You know, the black guy. Jeez. It's like watching a bad Dave Chappelle skit because it's real life, though. Good night.
Can you imagine being the defense secretary and watching the president not know your name in real time?
Yeah. He doesn't know who's running the military. He has no idea who's making these decisions. He doesn't know anything. And this was supposed to be one of the interviews that was supposed to redeem his FUBAR at the debate. It was supposed to, the thing that helped him, like, kind of recovered it. And then he did this. This is, yeah, play five. Let's get five queued up. Oh, you thought that one was bad. Go ahead. Go ahead and play this.
Make sure there's access to affordable internet, just like in Roosevelt's time. You know,
oh, Roosevelt's time with the internet. Yes, you know, the internet in Roosevelt's time. You know, because they had, you remember the internet during World War II? I don't know about you, but I remember my grandpa telling me about how he had learned on Twitter before Elon Musk bought it back in World War II when the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor. And he was like, well, you know, I saw that tweeted and then I snapped one of my friends and was like, I'm so enrolling, yo, going in the military, YOLO. And then he was out, right? You don't remember that? Your grandparents, you know, with their Snapchat accounts and the internet and Twitter, yeah, and all that, right?
That rotary phone dial-up internet was really slow back then, but it still worked.
Mm. Yeah, Grandpa told me it took like forever to text someone with a rotary phone.
Yep.
Yeah, yeah.
Tough.
And that Insta stories were still real clunky back then with the internet. Make sure the internet. Is he an alien? Because at this point, if he doesn't have Parkinson's and a stroke and I don't know everything else, then he's an alien. There is no other, literally no other option here. He either has all these ailments, or he's an alien because. It's like he's a person in a meat suit that can't figure out how it works yet. He can't. It's like a fleshy mecha suit, and he can't figure out how to do it right.
You may be closer than you think.
Gosh, that would be scary if like his face fell off and it's just like C-3PO under there. Are you concerned about the increasing instability in the world today because we have a bunch of desiccated old geezers who can't do math making monetary policy? You're not alone. We're all worried about what the future holds, but there is something that we can do about it. So that's why I've taken steps to safeguard my savings by going full Scrooge McDuck and diversifying precious metals with gold and silver. So after thorough research, I wanted to go with Goldco. It's a reputable company with a proven track record, and with their guidance, you know, you feel confident with your decisions. Goldco is a 7-time Inc. 5000 winner. They've helped individuals like us secure over $2.5 billion in gold and silver investments, and they're offering up to $10,000 in bonus silver. But you got to act fast because the supplies are limited. So join me in protecting your financial future. Visit DanaLikesGold.com because boy, don't I, and learn more and take the first step towards financial security. So by visiting the site, you also get a complimentary wealth protection kit to help you navigate inflation, geopolitical uncertainties, economic instability. But don't wait until it's too late. Visit DanaLikesGold.com today and start securing your future. That's DanaLikesGold.com.
That explains the whole beep, boop, boop with the arms. Dude, these interviews were supposed to help him. And the Democrats are now trying to push him out
he was on, Biden was on the phone call. Oh my gosh, this one was bad. He was on this phone call with all these folks, and it did not go well. He, I sent out prep email. I know. He read a note. This was crazy. So he was, let me pull this story up. You got this in your, if you get the newsletter, which you should, honestly, you get so many good things over at Chapter and Verse, my Substack. You get so many good things over there. But he was handed a note during, he had a phone call with Democratic House lawmakers. And apparently there were a couple of, I guess, members of the press. And the reason I say this is because they were tweeting about it at the time. And while he was on the phone, okay, while he's on this call with Democrat lawmakers, and he was yelling at them, he yelled at one Democrat lawmaker about his son's Bronze Star. I don't know if you, he got nasty with a Bronze Star Democrat. And it was really bad. Daily Beast, New York Post, they said he was rambling. Jason Crow, who's a Democrat out of Colorado, he's a retired Army Ranger. He was three tours in the Middle East, and he was a Bronze Star recipient. And Biden yelled at him, and he said, quote, first of all, I think you're dead wrong. And he goes, he was saying you've never done anything with your Bronze Star like my son or something. And he was yelling. And then this call, they were saying he couldn't complete an answer. He yelled at Crow. And then another said, quote, he was rambling. He'd start an answer. He'd lose his train of thought. And then he would just say whatever. He could not complete an answer. Another one said he was dismissive of concerns, unable and unprepared to present a campaign strategy. And that person's a sitting member of Congress. And it was a very tense call. And what's worse is he's handed a note while he's on this call. A staffer hands him a note. And it was a private note. And I'll be damned if he didn't read it in front of everybody. Biden. The note said, you are sounding defensive. Stay positive. And he read it. I am not making this up. It was the New York Times reported it. New York Post. Everybody. Associated Press. Everybody's reporting this.
End of quote. Repeat the line.
You are sounding defensive. Stay positive. Biden said it. And didn't even know that it was like a note, that a private note for him, not for him to share. Guys. So, I don't know. Chuck Schumer apparently privately told him he's got to go. Movement of Nancy Pelosi, if she comes out publicly and says something, I think he's got to. But they've already called a lid for the day. He's at his beach house for the next 4 days. And now everybody's watching him because they said if it happens, it'll be this weekend. And that's why they were trying to do that virtual election of him or nomination of him at the DNC. And Democrats apparently were really upset about it. They didn't like that. This is a disaster. They were freaking out about it. Democrat delegates were just freaking out about all of this. Listen to this audio soundbite 3. This is what he's telling BET. This is Biden trying to do outreach to the black voting bloc. Listen to this.
I'd like you to take a moment and tell black America what you want them to know. Why should they turn out for you?
Because they know where my heart is. They know where my head is. And by the way, if you notice, whether it's young blacks or young whites or white Hispanics or young Asian Americans, they've never focused until after Labor Day. I mean, the idea they're focused intently on an election right now is not there.
Wow.
And by the way, if you take a look at presidents who have...
Black people don't pay attention until after Labor Day, apparently. You know, I don't know. Good grief. That was supposed to, like, help him because he's hemorrhaging support amongst the black community. Kane's just... Are you okay?
How is it not... How are we still doing this? It's like we're just playing along. Like, what are we doing?
It's a million-dollar question here. Million-dollar question. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.